Welcome back to this series on Ionic, exploring Ionic Slider and the slide components with their APIs. In this one, we will take a look at a few more properties. So this one we're going to cut, first of all, let's look at the direction property. So the direction property, we saw it here in the swiper demo where you see, we have the vertical slider here where it goes vertically. By default, it's horizontal, so we can change it to vertical. That's what the direction property gives us. So by default, as I said, it's horizontal. We can change it to vertical. So let's do that. Let's add the direction and change it to vertical. And let's add a pager to it, so that we see the bullet pager. Alright, so that's it. You see we have a slide and it goes vertically. Yeah, it's a vertical line. Let's also take a look at the auto loop. So you see when we open, by default it is there, you have to slide. But what if you want to start showing the slides? You want to start looping programmatically. You want it to start sliding without the user touching. Well, that's what the auto loop is for. So the auto loop accepts a number, the number in milliseconds that it says the delay between transitions. So if this parameter is not passed, auto loop is disabled. Default does not have a value and does not autoplay. So when you put it there like that, just like that, autoplay, nothing will happen. You have to pass the value of the transition, the delay between the transition in milliseconds. So let's add, let's say 2,000 seconds, and let's see what we will get. So that's it. So every 2 seconds it will slide. Let me move on. All right, so you see it started again. You got one to the and that's it, it has ended. Let's add a loop so that it's when it gets to the fifth one and comes back to the first one, it will continue. So fourth, the fifth comes back to the first, and it goes to the second and the third. But when we don't add a loop, when it gets to the fifth and then comes back to the first, it will stop there. So that's it. We can change our right. That's it. We can change our time. Let's make it 500 half a second. Let's see. All right. Nice. Okay. Let's take a look at the space between. So by default, the space between the slides is 0 pixels. Now to get a nice to really see what's going on, let's add some background sorry colors. Okay, so style background. Let's give it this one. Alright. And then with our space between, we're going to give it a, let's say, five. Alright. Okay, so let's give it a slight head view so that we can really see what's there. Let's make it a slight head view too, so we can see the spaces. Okay, so that's it. Let's make our space 10 pixels, and we should see. You see? Increased. Now, there's one thing I want to mention here before we continue. The ion slide component takes the height and the width of its parent. So let's say we add a card here, and our card has a 200 pixel width and a 200 pixel height, and let's put our slides into it. Let's see what we will get. See, just taking the height and width of the parent. Let's remove the width so it takes the full width. Alright, so that's it. So you see, these slides takes the height and width of its parent. So if you want to have two slides, you can just do something like this. You can add another one, let's say three, and you get three slides on the same page. See? Alright. So that is it. Let's take a look at one last property. Let's look at the initial slide. So the initial slide chooses we use it to indicate the slide that we want to appear first. So by default is the zero. It's using the array count. So the first one is zero, the second one is one as it goes on. So we're going to say two. Let's see. So we should move to the third one. That's it. So that's it for this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.